Happy New Year! Happy New Year to everyone. I received good news this New Year. I just got my citizenship, Danish citizenship. Finally, I am truly Danish Pinay. So I received my statsborgerskap bevis. Statsborgerskap bevis, that means statsborger means citizenship. Rat means right. And bevis means certificate. So this is my citizenship certificate. See? Effective January 2018, signed by Inge Stoibe. Yay! I'm very, very happy to have a Danish citizenship. After 10 years here in Denmark, I have been through a lot to get this citizenship. I have to first have a permanent residency. In permanent residency, I have two requirements that was set to me before, is to have 3 years job, finish Danish language school, and have a volunteer work. So I did everything, all of that. I had an education also here. I had a job. I finished language school. I also started a organization before. So I did all of that. I passed all of that. And then after I got my permanent residency, I took an exam for Danish citizenship. And I also passed it. Yay! It's like out of 40, it's 40 questions, and then you could only have a maximum 8 mistakes. I think I have maybe 4 to 5 mistakes. And then when I passed that exam, I only took it once. I'm just happy because it's very, very difficult. That exam is like, you have to know, for example, when this Denmark became member of EU, when is the start where women have the right to vote, and also all the current happenings or information about Danish or about Denmark. So it's about history and also current information. Like, for example, I was in the time I had the exam, there was a question about who's the Danish astronaut. Good thing is I have been to planetarium, and then he have his display there, so it's still fresh before I took the exam. And I was also watching news, and yeah, so I could be informed, update with what's going on in Denmark. So I passed the exam, and after I passed the exam, I applied for Danish citizenship. I know that this year they make it even more difficult to just get a permanent. From 3 years, they make it 3.5 years to have work before you could get a permanent. So it's very difficult. It's not easy to have a permanent or Danish citizen. Danish citizenship, even though, for example, you're married to a Dane, or yeah, it's still difficult. It's very difficult to be a foreigner in Denmark. You need to be able to, I mean, you don't, maybe you think you don't need to learn the language, but it would really help a lot. So it's just so funny looking back at my first videos, how I pronounce Danish. When I was starting to learn Danish in language school, the reason why I made this YouTube video is just before, and my idea was just to see myself, how I speak Danish or how I pronounce Danish, you know? It's more of like my review to myself. When I speak Danish, do I pronounce it right? Is my grammar right? You know, it's more of like, because it's easier when you hear yourself speak, and then you could hear, okay, I think that's wrong. I think I pronounced it wrong. And then I also get feedback from my viewers. I remember before where some Danes are writing in my video and saying, oh, this is wrong, or this is the right way, or this is this. And So it really, this video, this channel also helped me a lot in my in my steps in learning Danish, because I'm also sharing what I'm learned, what I've learned from school, and also I want also foreigners like me to be inspired. Like if they see me in YouTube, like learning Danish, they could see themselves like, oh, that's also difficult for me, or you know, being in a language school also, they would see themselves to me, you know. So it's really nice. Well, now that I have the Danish citizenship, what are the advantage of me having that is because now I could travel anywhere, almost anywhere, without a visa. You know, like for example, if I want to go to USA or to England, places I've never been before, now I could use my Danish passport to go there. Because I know that if I only have the Philippine passport, there's a lot of limitations to where I could go. So it's really good that I'm planning to keep my Philippine passport or have a dual citizenship. So I am now Danish Pinay. I'm just happy. I'm really happy. I'm going to soon have my birthday next week, so it's the best gift for me. And I also, yeah, that's it. So to all foreigners who wants to have a permanent or Danish citizenship, just strive hard. And I wish you all good luck. It is all possible for us to have it. We just need to really work hard for it and be focused, have a goal. You need to set goals for yourself. Like before, when I moved here, I was thinking I just need to learn the language first. And when I went to Kumon, I signed the integration letter, and it says there, you know, all the requirements that they asked before for me to have a from temporary residency to get a permanent residency. I follow all of those, and after I finished the language school, I know I could not, it would be hard for me to find a job here because our education or background in the Philippines, it's not the same academical that they have. It's not the same education that they have here. So I studied and took course here, and then I work, and then now I'm going to study again. This February, I will start to get a new, I'm going to start with a new course. So wish me good luck, and I wish you also good luck, all of you. I wish that all of us will be successful and have a goals and set achieved our goals. So good luck. Bye-bye.